This woman has to cook daily. Every day she has to put food on the table and she has to use firewood. This is dangerous to the health of these women. These women inhale the smoke. The children who tag along also inhale the smoke, and the smoke has so many dangers. It can cause cancer. They can get bronchitis, and most of the time they are crying. And for pregnant women, they produce children with low birth weight. Most families do not have access to electricity for cooking, neither can they afford gas. All their life, they are exposed to this smoke. About 10,000 women die annually from Uganda because of using firewood and inhaling smoke from cookstoves.
The alternative that Betty has come up with is a charcoal briquette. It produces very little smoke. It's very similar to what folks in the U.S. or other countries might use for barbecues. Because it's already been fired and what we call carbonized, a lot of the smoke emissions have been removed from the fuel material. Through this work in East Africa that we're doing, a D-Lab at MIT is trying to merge impactful work with community partners and unique student experiences that immerse students in a different environment than they're used to.
I like working with the students because, one, the students bringing the rare expertise that I would not have been able to get from Uganda. And even myself, I'm able to ask them some questions, and they're able to ask me some questions.
So for this setup, the land cost is zero.
So being a training partner to MIT D-Lab, and also them sending their students to work with me, has been a win-win relationship.
I think the important thing to understand about the work that we're doing and that D-Lab's doing is that we're not trying to design for people, we're trying to design with them. Betty and her team are producing charcoal briquettes made from a mixture of charcoal dust from agricultural waste combined with a binder, and then they are formed using machines or by hand into these long briquettes that can be used for cooking. The more harmful gases are released in that first burn, and you're left with almost pure charcoal that has much slower and safer emissions than burning wood.
So one of the major challenges that the charcoal briquette producers are having is that drying is a real bottleneck. So drying the briquettes basically requires that you have a lot of space so you can lay these out and we can leverage the sunlight to dry those briquettes out. But in the rainy season, we don't have very much sunlight and they actually need to be covered up.
The main issue that we're trying to address is the rain problem. We're trying to make covers that will protect the briquettes from the rain without having to cover them with tarps. And we're also trying to increase the drying rate. We took into account the airflow present in Sorority, the heat that's present, the angle of the sun, all these factors that are going to affect the way that that heat and air interact in these dryers, while also putting a lot of focus onto locally available materials, lower priced materials, and minimizing costs so that scalability is maximized.
We believe that once we are able to scale up what we have learned from Danielle and her team, our production capacity will increase and the demand for customers will be met.
So the project work is really important, but another really important piece of this that we try to create, and here with Betty, we work very hard to introduce students to cultural experiences too. This past weekend we actually went to a pre-wedding introduction ceremony. One of Betty's employees, Immaculate, she was introducing her soon-to-be husband to her family, and they welcomed us into their home, and we were a part of that tradition in a big way.
I felt that it was very interesting for the students to witness what we do, to see what our culture is, and also to just feel part of the group. They appreciated what we do, and they also learned that cultures differ and you have to respect people, the way they behave, and it's dictated by their culture. Once we work together, we need to work as a team. When MIT comes, they don't come to teach us as experts. They come to work with us, but we learn from each other. So if we learned about what Danielle is teaching us on the solar dryer, we use that knowledge and scale it up, make more dryers, and also people come and learn from us.
Helping Betty in her business is great, but the most important part is the people that she's reaching and the people's lives that she's affecting. So we're just trying to help her reach that goal.
For me, I'm so happy. I feel like I'm a grandmother to these children because when they come here, I'm so used to having them every January. I don't know which year they would stop, but I would really miss them. Thank you.